Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Noma Factory GTCEU Expert Mode. Last time we were working on Kanthal coils and titanium, I believe. Or actually, no. That was a couple of days ago. I'm a little bit behind in the past here. And anyways, I'm distracted by what's coming up, which I'll just go on to that right now. As far as first thing that I'm gonna knock out is actually I'm gonna get this multi-smelter made. I already have almost all the pieces. So I've got muffler, energy, maintenance, output, input, heat proof, and wire machine casings, and so I'm gonna be smelting some stuff once I get this going. We'll get it all tested out, see how fast it smelts some stuff. I think I'm gonna be putting the multi-smelter right here. I cleared this little area out next to the steam grinder. I was Oh, here's one of the things that I made while off stream. As you can see, this is the Ender Fluid Link Cover. If you shift right click, this is just a link code that links to my oil setup. I have one of these on the other, the tank on the where the oil is, and these fluid covers can hold 64 buckets worth of whatever they're transporting, essentially. And so on the other side, it's got an import one, and then this one's the export side, and you have to make sure that the input output is enabled for it to work. And so, as you can see, there's oil here, 64 buckets, and this is constantly staying full. It's processing the oil, but it's constantly being imported or exported, whatever, however you want to call it, into here. And so that's constantly getting us, severely steam cracked light fuel, which in turn is getting us our ethylene. No more. It's way better than our previous setup because we used to have a tank here, right? And we'd have to bring the tank over to the oil setup, let it fill up. Then bring it back over here, connect it over here. But now I literally can just leave it and it'll just constantly keep going. So long as I don't run out of space. So I'm not currently exporting this ethylene into a tank right now. So this stops, of course, once it reaches 8 buckets. However, I have been using it a little bit. I did make some more PVC in here, and I made a decent amount more of the polyethylene. As you can see, our other fluids are still good. We're capped out on 8,000 buckets of benzene and nitrobenzene and nitrogen, and the other ones are still looking fine. So that's all good there. I did. So you can see there's 130 nichrome ingots right here. I did finish processing all of the nichrome in the blast furnace slash vacuum freezer. So we've got all those nichrome, so we can do the nichrome coils whenever we want to. And then I also have 130 kanthal ingots here. And this is what I'm planning on putting on the multi-smelter. I think I'm gonna use Kanthal coils for the multi-smelter. And then the nichrome will probably be going on the blast furnace. Now there is Kanthal coil blocks on this one currently. So if I do upgrade this to nichrome, I could always just use these Kanthal coil blocks inside the multi-smelter. And I think the multi-smelter only uses. So that one's 16 over there, but I think the multi-smelter is 8 coils. Also, I already prepared the main multi-smelter block here. You can see it's 3 furnaces, the processor assemblies, copper cables, and a heat-proof Envir machine casing. I just didn't take it out of the terminal yet, but now I can. So now that quest is complete, and we see the achievement. Multi-smelter complete. And this is gonna be nice once we get this set up because so it's really good, it's fast at smelting stuff, and you can obviously upgrade it to go even faster with the coils and power tier. At base level, it's 32 items per operation. I don't know how per level. I guess when it says per level, it's talking about the coils. So 32 items per level. So I guess at Cupernickel it'd be 32. Canthal it'd be 64 items, a whole stack per operation. And then 96 for Nichrome, I guess. And then it would obviously go to 128 after that for whatever comes after Nichrome. So that's gonna be nice. We're gonna get that set up here in just a few moments. And then we're gonna test it out smelting some stuff. And then also, I did prepare a cake base here. I'm gonna be making an end cake. Hopefully on this stream. But there is another thing that. So I'm gonna first do the multi-smelter. And then we're gonna take a look at here into the microverse. Now I did prepare the polished stone already, but we do have to put that in the resonator, which we do have, but we just have to get some grid power going there. And then we'll get 4 of these stone burnt items. And this quest is already done. We've already made red coal before, and black steel is already done too. But just to refresh real quick, it is a mixer steel, black bronze, void crystals, and red coal. And void crystals, of course, are coal and atomic reconstructor. Black bronze is a mixer, electrum, and copper with a circuit of 1. And then the red coal is, of course, coal and a resonator. So, yeah, that's that. So, we're gonna also knock out this, and then these two will complete also. And then, so the luminescence. We're gonna need luminescence, and actually, I already got started on the luminescence. As you can see over here, I've already crafted up 64 of them in the mixer here. And I'll go over that real quick. So, I did 8 sets of this, of course. So we took 16 aluminum, 8 glowstone, and 8 redstone for a full stack of luminescence, and 32 buckets of phosphoric acid, which I'll show you how I got the phosphoric acid real quick too. So there's 2 ways. I actually went the apatite dust way. And so for 32 buckets, you need to do like 11 sets of this, so you would need 99 apatite dust, some water, and if you want to do 11 sets, you would need 55 buckets of sulfuric acid, and that'll get you enough phosphoric acid for 64 luminescence essence. And so the luminescence is going to be used for these components, which are going to be used for the crafting table. So I think it goes, where's the, there's a basic one. Is this one, or wait, no, I guess this is the basic one. So this one requires luminescence, black steel plates, electrum, and glowstone plates. And then the advanced component is used for the advanced catalyst, as you can see here, surrounded by all of those and a black steel plate. And if you look at the extended crafting table, which is a 5x5 crafting grid, there's those advanced components in an X. And then there is basic catalysts, which are all of these, and then basic components, which are luminescence again, black steel iron, and nether quartz plate. So, we'll see how far I can get. First things first, we're going to do the multi-smelter, and then we can grind out some of this, and then perhaps make the ender cake to wrap up, but we'll see how long it's going to take to do all of this stuff. So, first things first, we're going to need some of these, and then an energy converter, I believe. Let's try, I think, an MV. I think this should be enough, right? For a blast furnace, an 8 amp. That's the only thing it's going to be using. It's only going to be attached to that, so I don't think we would need a times 16. Okay, so that's going to be finishing up here soon. And we'll go ahead and get this stuff set up over there. So looking at it, oh, right. We've got to get the coils. So it's 8 cupronickel, or we're not going to do cupronickel. We're going to do Canthal, right? So we're going to make 8 Canthal coils. Eight of them. So we would need 64 128 Canthal wires. We don't have the Canthal wires being auto crafted right now. Let me see if I can actually get this set up. I might as well, I guess. The only issue is that we're out of space here right now. Let me look here. So I don't have any, I was actually thinking of making an extra wire mill instead of adding a pattern expansion card on here. Because let's say a recipe requires electrum wire and gold wire, it's gonna have to wait for one of those to finish before doing the other one. But if I had this one in one of the wire mills and this one in another wire mill, it could literally do both of the wires at the same time. So if I split the wires up, it'll have a higher chance of potentially doing two wires at the same time, as opposed to them being all in the same wire mill. And same with these, but I don't think too many recipes use multiple of these in the same machine process steps. But I've seen it a couple times where there's multiple wires that have to be made at the same time. At least two different ones. But for now, I guess I'm just gonna do this manually. So, as I said before, we're doing 8. So we need 64 of the 2 times, which is 128 wires, which is realistically 64 ingots. So we're gonna have to put all of these into the wire mill. Not that one though, this one. So we'll start getting some canthal wires here. And then let's also get the aluminum foil going. So if we're making 8, so we need 64 aluminum foil. Guess I'll do it like that. Yeah, so 64. It's gonna make 64, yeah. Okay, so that'll start going. Gotta make the plates first. So we also need 8 ingots worth of copper. Eight. Okay, and we're gonna extract that in here. And then all of that has to go into an assembler at MV. Grab that. Let's see, what assembler do we want to use for this? Probably this one. Does it have to have a circuit? No, we can just leave it whatever circuit it's at right now. Okay, so aluminum foil is coming up. Canthal wires are done. Now we need to make these into 2x. So we'll just do that. Now we've got 64 of the 2x, which is enough for 8 sets. And then 64 of these. Okay. And then we'll come over to the assembling machine. Put those in there. Get some canthal coils coming up here. Looks like it'll take about 120 seconds for the whole thing. Okay. There's one canthal coil block right there. Two. All right, so while the coils are going, let's go ahead and come over here real quick and get like the first layer figured out here. So multi-smelter goes in the bottom center. Okay, so we want this one. And it's a 3x3, I think, right? Yeah. 3x3x3. Okay. Let's put like a couple spaces or so in between. So let's put it like right here, maybe. And then it'll extend out to here and here. Okay. So now we need an input and output bus. And then I guess the maintenance hatch and energy hatch, I think, can go anywhere on it, I think. Let's see. Does it say anything about that? No. Pretty sure they can go anywhere for the most part. So let's get the input and output. Put the input right here and output there. And then, okay. So we could, I guess we could put the energy hatch. We could put this stuff back there, I guess. The maintenance and energy hatch. Muffler goes at the top center. Do we want to put these back here? If we do, I kind of want to have room behind it to access. Oh, I forgot my mic was off there for a second. Hello, Kakaman. You love Greg Tech? Yep. This is my first time playing through Greg Tech. I've never played it before, so I've never seen all of the Greg Tech stuff. I haven't used it really before. Think we need one more. It's been quite an experience so far. Okay, there's a four red coal. Okay. And especially playing in an expert mode, definitely makes things a little bit more challenging. Yeah, modded Minecraft is definitely pretty awesome. So we're gonna put these into the mixer. Yeah, LV. So we should just be able to throw all of that in there. Get some black steel. Okay. I've grinded through a good amount. Well, a bit. Hopefully, I'm glad that we finally got into AE2 stuff, 'cause AE2 does make stuff easier for sure once you get access to that. All right, so we needed 18. 18. 19. 19 black steel plates. HBM's nuclear tech mod. I haven't done that one before. Okay, so we need 19, 16, 16 of these. Okay. And then I think we have to blast furnace. Okay, we have to blast furnace them. It only takes 10 seconds though. How is there, is that one have quest too? Oh. Nice, it only takes 3 seconds because we're running HV. Alright, those are gonna go straight to the AE2. At what voltage am I at? I've got some stuff at HV right now. This is pretty much the extent of HV. So, assembling machine, mixer, macerator. I've got a chemical bath. Also, I guess these are HV too. Centrifuge, this is our ore processing stuff, and then we've got a couple HV stuff here inside of the clean room. We do have titanium, a few titanium ingots, so we're getting closer to EV, but we're not there quite yet. Planning on going to the end, well, at some point in the near future. I got the cake base, I just gotta make it into a cake. And then we'll probably end up fighting the dragon at some point. But I wanna get this crafting table made so we can have that finished. Is there nuclear craft? There is not nuclear. Oh, wait, yeah, there is. Never mind. There is nuclear craft. I don't know. I'm assuming that's gonna be later. I don't know where they. I don't know if it's part of a quest thing somewhere or what, but I guess there is nuclear craft somewhere. I just don't know when they use it. It's because this is all like Greg Tech stuff, it feels like. Okay, so. For the advanced components, we've got to make this into plates. And then, right, glowstone and electrum plates. It said we needed 8 of each of those. I think it might just be. I think it's one glowstone. Per each plate. And then Electrum. Is that, yeah, that should be one plate too. Electrum. Now for the other plates, I don't know if you can go straight from. Let me look at that real quick. The glowstone plates. So we've got to extract the glowstone and then mold plate it in the fluid solidifier. Let's look like what we got to do for that. And then we're going to make the plates right here. Now that is going to go into the fluid solidifier. You haven't played Noma Factory before? Okay, so grab that. I think the plate mold is already over here. Yep. The other plate should be done too. There we go. Let's look at the other plates. We've got 19 black steel plates, and what was the other plates? Electrum, right. You have once and you quit after like 30 minutes because it was so boring. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely, I mean, it is quite a grind. I mean, obviously I'm playing expert mode. I don't know if you were, but it's definitely a bit of a, I guess, a struggle at the beginning, 'cause. Okay. But yeah, it's a struggle at the beginning for sure. Definitely not, I guess you would say, fun by any means. So you don't have. Everything's pretty hard to do at the beginning. You don't have access to stuff, so. Right, so I think we have some of the stuff that we need now. We're gonna need the nether quartz plates at some point, so let me grab those. The rubber wood planks, those are gonna be for chests. Gonna need. Okay. So let's look at this quest right here, right? Advanced components. It says we only need to make one, but I'm gonna make four of them because that's what we're gonna be making at some point. So I might as well make four. So if we're gonna make four of these, it's gonna be four, 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 four in here. We could just do that. We just put all of this stuff in there actually. One, two, three, four. And that quest is complete. Nice and simple. And now for the advanced catalyst. Oh. Right, that's going to require four advanced components, so we're going to have to make even more. So this requires four, and it also requires four, so you need eight total. Okay, let's get four more. There we go. And now to make the advanced catalyst, nice and simple. That's all done. Quest complete. And now that unlocks the advanced extending crafting table quest, which we can knock that out, except we've got to make the two basic catalysts and crafting stations. So we need two of these, which means we're gonna need eight of these. We're missing iron plates. I guess we need eight iron plates. Right? I think so. Right. Right or wrong? Two of these. Requires, yeah, 8 of these. Yeah, okay. 1, 2, oops. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. I don't think that was a quest though, right? Yeah, there's not a quest for this stuff here. So now we need to make the basic catalyst times 2. There we go. That's done. Why is the ore spawning in Gregtech so realistic though? Are you talking about like the ore veins? Yeah, it's definitely an interesting way how they went about doing the ore compared to regular Minecraft or other mods, how they just use the regular vanilla generation for it. All right, the crafting stations. So we need. I mean, theoretically, I could just put these as an autocraft, the crafting stations, but I don't consider it important enough to do that. So we need two crafting tables. So we need two wood and two flint. I don't think I have any flint in here, so I have to go upstairs to grab it. But that shouldn't take long at all. Now let's go back downstairs. Slash. And we need to put this in the assembler with a circuit. Doesn't matter. Put those in there. Did you ever play New Horizons? Nope. This is the first Gregtech stuff that I've played, this mod pack specifically that includes it. So we've got the crafting tables. Wait, do we need four chests? I think we need four. Right, we need four chests. Let's make two more. I've played. Besides this one, so there was like a long break that I took. I played like FTB Infinity Evolved before this a wa long time ago. So that had like it had like a Avaridia and all that stuff, like the end game stuff, and I did get to it. I had like a huge amount of ingots, like millions of each kind of ingot. And I had like, I forget, there was some sort of book that took, I forget what it was called, but you could like put it in, put items into it. And it would like convert it into some sort of like energy, let's call it. And then you could take that energy and like each item had an energy amount or whatever. I forget what it's called. It escapes my mind. But let's say Canthal coil blocks would have like, let's say 1,000 cost. But you could take like 10,000 cobblestone, convert it into the energy, and then you could literally just grab a Canthal coil block out of it. But it was like, yeah, it was Project E. That's what I'm thinking of. That is what I'm thinking of. Where did the crafting tables go? There they are. Yep, that's what I'm thinking of. Two, wait. Not two, four planks, but times two, so eight. Eight. Okay, so we put this all in the assembler, yes. Yep. That is it. Okay, so I think we can make this now. There we go. That quest is complete. Advanced extended crafting table, 5x5 grid. And so I'm glad we were able to knock through all of this stuff right here. That was quite a few quests. Now I kind of want to make the end cake. I don't know if I'm gonna go there just yet, but I at least want to have the end cake made. And I don't know where I'm gonna put this crafting table yet. Cake. Right, so the end cake is gonna be three more black steel plates. So we've got to take that and furnace these in the blast furnace. Let's do that. Okay, that's good to go. And then, oops. Okay. So I have the Eyes of the Ender, but I do have to get the Endstone Dust times three. And I'm thinking, we're gonna have to get this. We're gonna have to do this. Luminescence and lava, I believe. Think. That's how we're gonna get that, right? Pretty sure. Luminescence and lava, and we need, I think, six? Wait, no, three, right? Should be, yeah. So we need three endstone. So three luminescence and three buckets of lava. I think I can convert the magma blocks into lava, right? Yes, a chemical reactor. Let's get that ethylene out of there. Put it right here for now. Let's get these into here. Okay, so we've got the lava and we need three luminescence. Where did our luminescence go? Did we put it in here? We did. Okay. And then, so let's grab the lava, put it over here, and then put that in there. There's our end stone, and now we have to pulverize it. So we'll come over here, put that in there. There's our end stone dust. Nice and simple. And now I think we can probably make the end cake. Oh wait, where did the black steel plates go? Did we not? We put. Oh, we made the ingots, but we didn't make them into plates yet. That's what. Okay, now it should be good. Here and here. There's our end cake, and I believe that is a quest, I think. Yes, it is. The end question mark. And that quest is down here. The end portals and strongholds are disabled. The only way to access the end is to bake a cake. You can refill it with Eyes of the Ender, prepare some gear, eat a slice, and get ready for a fight. Okay. Egg Thief. Find a clever way to make the Ender Dragon's egg to fall onto a torch. A dragon egg mill to place it on for a free 500 grid power. Distilling liquid ender air. Right, so we could put a gas collector in there. And then I think we would to get it from the Nether to here, I think we can use the Ender Fluid Link covers. Believe that's how we'd want to do that to get it over into here. It says it can be sent into. Well, you turn it into the, you would make it go into the vacuum freezer, and then you would take that, put into the distillation tower. Why can't I click that? Liquid Ender Air. Okay, so this is what you get for putting 200 buckets of liquid Ender Air. Radon, that's actually going to be useful, I believe. Krypton. Nitrogen dioxide. A lot of that. But the radon, I think that was for the. Oh, yeah. That's going to be for the quantum eyes. That was what I was thinking about. So you can get four quantum eyes for every 200 buckets, looks like. I'm gonna go upstairs and put this cake down where the other one is. I guess we'll put it right there. Okay. Dun, 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 dun. Let's see. Trying to think here of what I want to tackle next. So we obviously have titanium a little bit. Oh, nichrome coil blocks. We could get the coil blocks made because we do have the nichrome ingots to make it. I don't think we're going to be using the nichrome ingots for anything else, right? Like, I'm pretty sure it's just the coil blocks that it's useful for, probably. I don't know. I'm really not seeing too much else in terms of nichrome. Unless it's like. Would you use nichrome cables? Anything else? What about two times? We use two times nichrome cables for advanced electronic furnace, but I don't really care about that because we've got the multi-smelter. Are you approaching endgame? No. Definitely not. Advanced extruder. Alloy smelter. So you do need nichrome for some of this EV stuff, it looks like. Thermal centrifuge, extruder, alloy smelter, fluid heater. What about eight times? Nothing. Sixteen? Okay, nothing. Okay. Yep, there's I'm really only a little bit into the mid game, I guess technically. I've gotta go to like I guess like the moon and stuff. I've gotta get to the end. Obviously I made the cake, so I can go there now if I want. And fight the dragon. But I've got to go through all of the EV stuff. And once I get through, you've got to do the micro miners, of course. And some of this. We've got to probably upgrade our power stuff too at some point. And then here's the late game stuff. And also, late game. Obviously, I haven't touched late game at all. But then after late game, then I guess you can either do fun with fusion or end game stuff. Which is, you can see there's some Avaradia stuff here. And a tier 10 micro miner, which is pretty spooky. It's a lot of stuff there for that. Looks very fun. Can't wait to do that. And the infinity stuff. The infinity stuff that I'm used to making compared to in here with the expert mode, it is way more difficult to make infinity. So this is for one infinity ingot, right? So it's like Omnium and Eternal Catalyst and Infinity Catalyst. So the Infinity Catalyst is a bunch of piles of neutron, Eternal Catalyst, Chaotic Core, Heart of a Universe, and then, so that's the Infinity Catalyst, right? And then you've got the Eternal Catalyst, which is all of these motes of Omnium, all of these different kinds of gears, you've got different kinds of stars, you've got the ultimate material, which is all of this stuff. So these recipes are very quite insane to deal with. All of this stuff is well, that one's not too bad. It doesn't look like, assuming you have the stuff, but some of the recipes are definitely quite difficult, or they look difficult at the very least. And they just require a bunch of different materials to make. Pretty much. So I'll eventually get to this end game, but first I've gotta get past the mid game stuff. And then we can look forward to that stuff. So Nichrome, 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 Nichrome. I guess we might as well make the Nichrome coils, because then we can upgrade our blast furnace with it, and then all of the recipes that are 1800K and below will get efficient overclock and a 2x speed boost. So, for example, steel ingots, right? Well, even stainless steel, I think. Yeah, so stainless steel is 1700. So now it'll cut the time in half for that. And steel and a bunch of other stuff that we've been doing in the blast furnace. So that'll be nice to have. So we need 128 nichrome. And so we need 16 of these, right? So we need 128 nichrome 2x wires. Or, yeah. So 128 of the 2x wires and 128 stainless steel foil, which is going to be 32 stainless steel ingots. So let's get, so we need 32 stainless steel, and we need to convert all of this into wires. Oh, and that was a quest for, the progression, I believe, or end game. Nichrome should be either here or over here. Yeah, that quest. Okay. Oops, not early, mid game. So, right, we're gonna convert all of these into wires. Put those in there. And then we're gonna go over to the bending machine. And we need to make all of that into stainless steel foil. So let these things go for a minute here. And then once we've got that, we also need 16 ingots worth of aluminum molten. So let's get that going. 16. And I'm going to put that in the extractor. Okay. This is also the 20. What is it? 26, 29, 30. I think this is the 32nd stream that I've done so far. 32nd stream of this mod pack. And I spent probably almost on average 2 hours on each stream. So I'm definitely well over, well, just 50 hours, more than 50 hours on stream, but then I'm also doing stuff on stream, or off stream rather. So definitely have put in quite a bit of work, and I'm only on the mid game right now, of course. Okay, so that stuff will be done here soon enough. Let's get Nichrome going here. We've got a bunch of these, and we have to make them into 2 times. 128. And the bending. Oh, grab that. That's just about finished, and we'll go put these in the sem. Oh. Let's go ahead and put this into the assembler. It's not that one, it's this one. Okay, we've got foil times 128, and then is it still making more wires? Yes, it is. Fifteen left. I guess I can start throwing these into the assembler right now. I think it has to be HV. Yes, it does. So this will not work here. We've got to go over to our HV assembling machine, and that's got polyethylene in it, of course. So what we're gonna have to do is disable the fluid export bus, get the polyethylene out of there, and then put the aluminum in. Do we have enough now? Where's our other nichrome wires? We should have 64. Oh, wait, some of them are probably in the assembling machine already. I think I put some in there. Did I? No? What? Oh, are they in this one over here still? Ah, there. Okay. So let's grab that out of there, put this in there, and then put all of this in there. Okay, so that's gonna take 20 seconds at 16, gonna be 320 seconds, so about 5 minutes for all of this to finish. So we'll let that do its thing. There's the first nichrome coil block. And so once that finishes, we'll get it installed in our blast furnace. What mod packs did you play before this one? I've played the ones that I can recall anyways. I did Project Ozone and the FTB Infinity Evolved. Those are the two that I can recall right now. Don't know what I'm doing with the stone burnt right now, to be honest. It's used for certain stuff. A lava mill, water mill, windmill, fire, dragon egg. Solar. Rainbow stone. What is this for? Just for looks? Looks pretty cool. Okay, so we've got that going. This quest will be complete soon enough. And then, so this requires EV machine holes and nichrome coil blocks. Eventually, So tungsten is required for EV electrolyzer, and wait. Oh, it requires an EV electrolyzer to make tungsten. Also, you need an LV extractor and an electric blast furnace with at least nichrome coils. So it's a good thing we're upgrading our blast furnace to nichrome. EV chemical reactor can also be used if you want tungsten dust. Endstone dust. You can get it from centrifuging that, the tungstate. Blah, blah, blah. First option is recommended as it saves hydrogen and takes less time to cook in the EVF. First option. So I guess that would be cooked in an EVF with carbon to get tungsten, rather than chemically reacting with hydrogen to achieve tungsten dust. So it recommends the EVF option with carbon. Which is, I guess, this one technically. Either this one or this one. So tungsten dust. I don't think we do any of this stuff, no. Tungsten dust. I think we have to use the chemical reactor. So we would need tungsten trioxide and hydrogen. And then to get tungsten trioxide, looks like we're gonna have to use the extractor on tungstic acid dust and then chemical bath, either scheelite or tungstate dust with hydrochloric acid. I think. Wait, what's tungstate again? Tungstate ore. Can we get. Okay, tungstate ore is only on the end of the moon. Just trying to look at this real quick here while that stuff is being made. Tungstate and then scheelite. Scheelite ore. But I think you can get this from a byproduct or something, right? Is that what it was saying earlier? Or no? No, it says you have to get them tungstate and scheelite from the respective ores. Oh, tungstate is obtainable in small quantities from centrifuging endstone dust. Tungstate. Tungstate? I don't even see that here. Tungstate. Tungstate dust? So, oh, it's probably gonna be like tiny piles or something that you can get. Wait, small? Centrifuge. Okay. Endstone dust is one small pile, which is a fourth of a tungstate dust. So every four, you would get one tungstate dust, and then you put the tungstate dust and hydrochloric EV. You need an EV. I have to go now. Keep up the Greg Tech grind. All right, bye. Thank you for stopping by. Have a good rest of your night. I'll see ya. Okay, so we do that, and then tungstic acid extract, get tungsten trioxide. Then combine it with blast furnace, carbon, EV, nichrome, get these, hot tungsten, and then you get the tungsten ingot and the vacuum freezer. Okay, so that's the process it looks like. Is the nichrome coils done? Nichrome. 16. And quest complete. craft a nichrome heating coil advancement. Okay. So, quest complete and an advancement. Let's go ahead and break this Canthal. And then replace it with this new Nichrome. Nichrome. Think the center has to be hollow. Oh boy. There we go. And structure formed, maintenance fine. Heat capacity 3700K. Looking good on the heat capacity there. Good coils in there now. Pretty good, at least. And now, if we want to make steel or whatever, should be twice as fast and more energy efficient too. Perfect. Good. And that'll also be useful for the tungsten when we get to it, although we have to upgrade it to EV instead of HV at some point. But we'll get more into the EV energy stuff when we get a little bit, just a little bit closer. So, yep, we knocked out definitely quite a few quests. EV machine hole. So, for the EV machine hole, right, it's going to require 8 titanium. And 2 aluminum cables. And polyethylene. So, it's not too bad, except for the fact that it just takes a really long time to get titanium. Because we've got to process a lot of bauxite to get rutile right now. And obviously, it's one rutile equals one titanium. Unfortunately, that's how the ratios work. So this is like 11 titanium. And we've got 12, so we've got 23 in total, which is enough to obviously make a machine hole, EV machine hole. But not, I mean, we can make two if we wanted, but I don't think we can make three right now, even if we process the rutile, you know. Titanium double plates. Used for two things, tier two and the space station assembler. Okay. We're not gonna worry about the tier two micro miner, because we're gonna have to first tackle the tier one micro miner, which is, for whatever reason, I don't think it's on this page. I think it's, is it this one? Yes. It's on the Into the Microverse page, not the mid game. And so, just looking forward here real quick. This is going to require probably all of the stuff above it. Phosphorus, quantum, rocket fuel. There's definitely a lot of space stuff here. Rocket fuel's right here. And this one requires that. So we've got to go through this whole process up here of getting rocket fuel, which is dimethyl hydrazine, when this requires dimethylhydramine and chloramine, which are these two. And that requires ammonia and a methanol, so we have those We have ammonia, but it just doesn't say complete. But we do have ammonia right now. And methanol, we don't actually have. But I think. I wonder if it's good to do fermented biomass for that. It's either that or wood vinegar, it looks like. Unless you want to. I don't know if it'd be good to do a chemical reactor or not. Maybe. Carbon dioxide and hydrogen. That's a lot of hydrogen. We have 728 buckets of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. So we've got a lot of carbon dioxide if we wanted to do this, for example, but it would eat a lot of hydrogen. I mean, we do have 3,500 buckets, so that's a good amount, but I think it would eat through it pretty quickly once we start making it. I don't know how much we're gonna need per se. But so next time I'm thinking that we might go take a trip to the end and take out the dragon, slay it, and it'll give us a dragon heart, and we'll obviously have the egg for fun, I think. And then, as you can see here, this is like the after quest. Now that you've dealt with the dragon, assuming we've killed it, you would go to the bedrock structure around the edge, floating mid-air around the edge of the main island. Carefully throw an enderpearl inside one, where there's a portal-looking texture to teleport to a distant island, and it wants us to gather some chorus flowers. Not sure what that's for. You have to smash the flower itself. Simply breaking the stem will not drop the flower. And then draconium dust. Its ore spawns in small quantities but should be everywhere. Then you throw an enderpearl into another bedrock portal structure to get back to the main island. Okay. So yeah, we'll definitely probably tackle the end next time, and we'll take a look. I know there is some ores there that are gonna be useful to us. I don't know if this is here on the moon. Okay, so yeah. Ilmenite. This will be useful for us because we can get rutile dust. For every 10, we get 4 rutile dust. So I think once we get access to Ilmenite in the end, assuming we can get it somewhat easily there, it does say vein weight of 40. I don't know if that. I mean, I don't know how low that is. I don't. I mean, I'm assuming the vein weight changes like either like how easy it is to get it like or like within the vein itself, I'm guessing. So the higher the number, the easier it is to find it inside of the vein, I think. And we're gonna be looking for a bauxite vein in the end when we get there. But anyways, so yeah. I think we'll be taking a trip to the end here real soon. Fighting the dragon. And then we'll probably go mining, getting some stuff there, doing that quest. Explore the island, of course, one of the outer islands. And we'll obviously. We're still. I mean, I can mine more bauxite, but at the same point, I just want to get to the end. So that way I can do the Ilmenite stuff instead. Tungsten. Right. We were looking at that earlier. Quantum Eye. Yep. Right now, like, even if I make an EV machine hole, right? So if I make an EV machine hole, that requ unlocks advanced alloys, which is all of these four. And those are used for building the alloy blast smelter. And then it unlocks the EV circuit assembling machine, assuming you have quantum eyes done though. And as we said earlier, to get the quantum eyes unlocked, we need the radon, which we get from liquid ender air, I believe, is how we do that. So I guess we'll probably be getting that's a tier two. I guess we can eventually get radium salt, which can get us radon, but that would require the tier two micro miner. Mercury and gold, but that was a fusion reactor, so out of the question there for now. And this is HV chemical bath, so yeah. I'll try to tackle that stuff next time. Get to the end. Explore it. Maybe set up a gas collector over there so we can start getting some liquid ender air going. And then maybe that's what we'll put in our distillation. Oh, it does have to be IV though. The distillation tower has to be IV. And right now, I think it's MV. So we're gonna have to upgrade the energy hatch. I think we can add. I think for IV, we would maybe need two HV hatches back here, I'm guessing. But I'm not 100% sure. But yeah. So, anyways, I think we're gonna wrap up here. And, I'll see you next time. And, thank you for watching. And, bye for now.